If you can make it right now during this market, you can crush any other market. Is going to be a cakewalk to you. And let me tell you something, when it swings, it's going to swing fast, it's going to swing hard. It's going to be like, it's going to make your head spin how quick things turn around. So my advice is Ayub.
Hey, Ricky.
All right, bud. All right. This is your time to shine, man.
Oh, yeah. I know. You know, what a journey. What a journey being with you for the past almost a year. When I volunteered to come on the show, I didn't know what to ask you, you know, because we meet twice a week and I couldn't think of any question that you couldn't have answered. So... but then I still came up with a couple of them, you know, for the sake of the show.
Yeah.
They could have been answered like a zillion times already. But I would love to ask you, why not?
Let's do it.
If you ask me about my challenges in the business, is how can I create listings in this market, in today's market, when there is no inventory? Sellers are not selling, buyers are lined up, you know, buyers are being priced out. How I can help my buyers find a property for them?
Well, man, that's a great question, and I'm sure it's on everyone's mind. You know, the first thing to realize is that we're in a market cycle, right? And this market cycle is the toughest as I've ever seen, right? The amount of effort per transaction is at an all-time high. If you can make it right now during this market, you can crush any other market. Is going to be a cakewalk to you. And let me tell you something, when it swings, it's going to swing fast, it's going to swing hard. It's going to be like, it's going to make your head spin how quick things turn around. This is a short-lived market. Maybe it lasts a year or two or 6 months or 3 months or 3 years. I don't know. But all that is not that long in the whole scheme of things, right? It'll be here before you know it, and boom. So my advice is let's do everything we can do to build our databases up and take what transactions we can out of the process and count those as bonuses towards just surviving during this time, right? Because we know if we can survive, we can really crush it. Now, to your question, I think there's a pent-up demand of people who really want to list their house. They're just scared to because A, there's nothing to buy, and B, they're scared they're going to leave money on the table. Right? So I think there's a lot of people who really do want to sell at today's prices. They're greedy, and they want to see if they can make a little more and then a little more. I think a couple things to think about in today's market is second homes and investment properties. Okay, people that are not living in their home, in the property. Okay, people that are living in their property, if they sell the house they're living in, where are they going to go? Okay, there's nothing to buy, right? So there's nobody really moving and upgrading and downgrading right now in this market. Everybody's sitting put. This is another reason why I believe there's pent up demand for people who want to list, because there are people out there who want to upgrade. They're in a smaller home than they really want, or they just had another child in the last year and they need an extra room. There's a lot of people, I believe, that would love to upgrade to a bigger home or a newer home or a nicer home that can't because there's nothing for sale. But when this thing swings, and it's going to swing hard and fast, you know, we're going to see the market turn around where people are going to be ready. When the moment happens where they can actually get out and upgrade, we're going to see a nice uptick in possible listings and stuff. So guys, be ready for this and build your databases now to be ready for this moment. But going after people who own second homes and investment properties that aren't living in their properties, those are the ones we need to be going after right now, because they've got equity. Right? They've got profit sitting there, and they can sell that property. It doesn't affect their life. They made money on that property, and now they can just sit back on their profit and wait on the market to come back down or something like that, right? Everybody's situation is different. I'll tell you, Red X has a feature for rent by owners, right? This is like probably the most untapped, amazing leads that right now in today's market, because these are investors who are renting these properties long term, right? They're investors. This isn't a house that they're living in. They've got equity. There's profit on the table. So I think A, understanding where we are in the market cycle and what we need to really be achieving. B, going after a second home and investment properties, people that can sell those properties, make a profit, and not worry about where they're moving to next because they weren't living in that property in the first place. And C, circle prospecting the neighborhoods that your buyers want to buy in and just trying your best to find a seller. Then it's an off-market deal. You're not competing with 30 buyers. Guys, listen to me loud and clear. You find the seller for your buyer, you're not competing with 30 buyers anymore. It's off-market. You're not competing with 30 buyers, 15 buyers, 8 buyers, and multiple offers and higher than full price, right? If you find an off-market seller who would sell, they don't want to list it. We've heard that before, right? They don't want to list it, but they would sell it. Okay, great, I can bring you an offer. Let's present it to the buyers. Let's let them come over and look and see what happens. So I think it comes down to the nitty gritty of it, Ayub, that we just have to do the best we can do with what we got. You know, and it's not going to be perfect right now. It is the toughest market I've seen. And we just got to keep fighting and keep grinding it out here until we get to an easier market. And it's just going to... I can say, man, I'm just so excited about the direction of the market here because, you know, it's just exciting to watch all this go down. I mean, this is history. We're witnessing history of the real estate market, man, and I'm just excited to be here in the middle of it.
What happens is my mornings are pretty okay. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm committed from 9:30 to 1:30 or something, and after that, I'm kind of lost. I'm just drifting here and there.
Got you. Got you.
To schedule that and commit that part of my afternoon to something that I can really capitalize on.
Start dabbling with social, man. Start dabbling with it and being like proactive, putting work behind it, you know, spending an hour or two a day, doing it the sweat equity way, not the buying leads way, you know, doing it by liking and commenting under people who are following you's post, DMing them and saying, congratulations on whatever the post is about, you know, how's it going today? Having real genuine connections with people online is something you could spend hours doing that'd be super beneficial, where you could, again, collect data. I'm thinking calls from 9 to 12 and digital in the evenings, email, text message, social media, DMs, posting, commenting, responding to comments, replying, you know, following up, one-on-one emails, weekly email, you know, the whole nine yards, just crushing digital in the evenings, DMing every single person in your market that you can find that lives in your market. Hey, how you doing? They go to your profile, they see you're a real estate agent in their market. I mean, that's just something, if you find yourself lost and you're burnt out on the calls for the day and you've made your 3 hours of calls and you're doing your weekly email, move over to digital and play around for a little bit. I promise you, I think you'll connect with some people. You know, you may pick up 3 or 4 or 5 good leads a day. Yeah, add that to your repertoire and see what happens.